can stretch. I just made a mess. I just made a mess. I got cash by the bundle, so I'm never pressed. I just made a mess. I just made a mess. 50 yard TD with the winning catch. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no, no, no.
gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction to the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football in Big D, as their guys will do battle with the New York Giants. Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. Taking it about the one. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. They run it for the first time with Tony Pollard. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down. Well, this defense, Charles, really played well in that win a week ago.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away four times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw the ball? Do you try and run it more? Or do you tell your quarterback, make sure you see your guys open before you deliver?
Now a throw here to his running back. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds.
Well, they use him a lot out of the backfield. He had five catches a week ago, and he makes another catch here for good yardage.
Into the secondary, past the 40, and finally down at the 41-yard line.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight-ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
They fake the handoff. Now Murray. And the giant rush gets home as down. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Hands it off out of the gun. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. They get 2 yards back, but they're going to need a lot more than that here on third down. Here's Murray. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got a bump down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now. First and 10, right at the 40. They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it second and 6.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about 4.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. That's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that because now it doesn't go on the books, but now they have to make that up again, don't they?
The eighth play of the drive coming up. It's third and three. And they'll try and run the option to pick it up. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Pretty ideal right there. Keep it yourself, get the first down, and get the heck out of bounds.
And knowing him, I believe he's thinking, I can get a few more yards if I just lower my shoulder. But he also hears that second voice in his head, his head coach, or probably his agent too, saying, get out of bounds, man. Don't do that.
From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Linebacker Patrick Queen bringing him down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Murray flips his forward on a jet sweep. And this will be a gain of 6 when it's all said and done, down to the 15 from the 21.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Big completion there on third and short. Keeps their opening drive alive.
Not only alive, but plenty of possibilities now. First and goal, and you know me, I'm a big advocate. If you're going to throw the ball, throw it early in the down and distance count.
Now Murray off play action. Escaping the pressure right. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. Second and goal from inside the 5. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. They'll wind up losing 11 on the play. And that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal. No score after one on EA Sports. Interested to see what they dial up here. Third and goal with a lot of green between them and the end zone. Murray now. Murray fighting. Lost the football. Bad place to fumble down here in the red zone. At least they got it. They'll have another shot. Or no, they won't have another shot. It's going to be fourth down. Maybe they can at least salvage 3.
And they were thinking 6 points because at this position of the field, it's go time, right? You take your shots at the end zone. They weren't able to do that one. So you look over the sideline. There's the head coach saying, oh, heck, kick it. Field goal time.
So a pretty good opening drive. That'll make the home fans somewhat happy. They wanted 6, but they got 3 in the early lead.
And they should be happy. The guys look good getting down the field. That's got to give them a little bit of hope that good things are in store here today for them.
And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. So from inside the 20, here's 1st and 10 at the 18. And this defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. Officially no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down. They'll set up a throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Carl Willis. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown.
We constantly talk about defenders having great vision and being able to see plays unfold and make their own plays. But you also have to have good feel as well because you can't see everything out there. See the play unfold. Feel what's going on, and then get to the right spot and make your own play. And in this case, it turned out to be a highlight one.
Extra point by Sly is up and good, and the lead grows to 10-0. He will return this from deep in the end zone, and he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
For most people, the excitement of a kickoff return is to see a long one that goes back in the opposite direction. But for the guys covering it, it's being able to stop them deep in their own territory. How about that incredible form tackle right there? Shouldering the ball carrier, and down he goes.
Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. They'll look to throw now on first down. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. On play action, they'll throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And that is incomplete.
So, Charles, you talk about this head coach and his future with this franchise. Look, it's been a frustrating year, and I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier in the week.
Yeah, he's trying to say all the right things, isn't he? But he's heard the rumors. He knows what's going on out there. And right now, he is tired of having to answer the question, are you on the hot seat in every meeting with reporters? This week, he kind of said, I've had enough, and I don't blame him. He looks like a guy that may very well be out the door.
And Bohorquez on to punt as he gets it away. 31 yards on the punt there. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
And they are back down to 500 following the loss last week. Consistency has been a real issue for them so far.
Brandon, you almost don't know what team is going to show up every week. I mean, there's no consistency with this ball club at all. And if we feel that way, I know it frustrates the coaching staff. And it also has to frustrate the key leaders in the locker room. They got to figure out how to get coordinated.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard. Play fake. Murray. On the move to his left.
Open man is Kmet, the tight end.
And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll fight forward on the straight ahead running for just a couple of yards, second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to third down. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Here's Murray.
He'll get that complete to his tight end, Kmet.
And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. 10-0, our score. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. On play action, it's Murray. A rifle's run, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Eric Stokes. And the Giants are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And it's been a rocky start for them thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it on the first drive.
Punt's better than the turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're hoping to turn into first downs and hopefully points.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
You know, if following up on this head coach and the pressure that he is under, CD, I want to switch it to you because you've been on winning teams, but I know you've been in similar situations too where things just are not going well. How do you approach that as a player?
It's a tough approach, Brandon, because you
nowhere to go here. He lost the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And this is going to be brought back for a fumble return touchdown by the Cowboys. So that is now two fumble return touchdowns. And you're talking about something that's going to drive a head coach crazy.
Without a doubt. But for the defensive guys, once you do it once, you create a frenzy. Everybody wants to get involved, and they got it done a second time.
Extra point by Sly is up and good, and that makes our score 17-0. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
And in just about every game we see, partner, what do? When we look at the stat sheet, we go right to
the turnover differential.
Without a doubt, because when we see that, that pretty much tells the tale of the game. And I know there's still plenty of time to go, but you've got to take care of the football in order to win it.
The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. One play has them up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. They're going to look to throw. Throwing left side, it's complete. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. Oh, very close to a turnover there in the end zone.
I believe I'm following their logic. Take the big shot downfield, loosen things up. You're hoping to get some points on the board before the half. Maybe now you come back and throw some underneath stuff in order to make sure you get a completion.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit. And they get one here in the passing game.
Again, he'll drop the throw. And he's going to hook up with his big tight end. Complete. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. Working with a second and three. Back to throw again. And this is going to be intercepted.
Picked off by Corey Willis. And the Cowboys are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20.
Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it. His teammates are going to check on it. Because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half. I mean, that just didn't happen. From the 27, Murray swinging this out for Pollard. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Throwing on first down is Murray. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Murray is going to float this one deep right side. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Cowboys!
It's so easy to focus on the speed and elusiveness of Kyler Murray, but as he shows right there, don't sleep on the arm strength.
And I'm telling you, nothing will light up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield, and you know everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open. What a connection there for the touchdown.
So just eight ticks remaining here in the first half as they'll kick this one away. Taken at the goal line. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And with 5 seconds to go, this will likely be our final play. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked up by Javon Holland. And the Cowboys are going to get the football back as time will run out in this third quarter of play. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Giants set to get the football, and they trail here as we get back underway in the second half. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Blitz coming and down he goes. He'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's third down. Now back to throw. Under pressure, and they got to him again. It's a loss of 10 on the sack, and it leads to fourth. And the Giants send out their punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he'll try and hurry the kick, gets it away, but it's not looking that great. And that one didn't accomplish a whole lot. It'll be down inside the 35-yard line. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. And to give this time to the tailback. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and 3 now.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Now a handoff looking right. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
He needed three. He got two. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on fourth and a yard. Set him back five. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He made his first, this from 47 yards out. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And the lead increases even further. It's 27-0 now. So little by little, the better of these two sides starting to become more and more apparent.
3 points is not a knockout blow in the third quarter, but when the other guys haven't shown they can do anything, they don't have any points. This is looking pretty good. Maybe not a knockout blow, but a good stiff jab, that's for sure.
From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. Well, he gets attended to, we'll step aside. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to this offense. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Greg Newsom. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. Boy, you just kind of feel for him right now. 4 interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game. Go to the press conference. Meet it head on and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today. And you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity. Now a handoff here to his running back. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. And he'll give it here to his running back. Down to the 25. 1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 11.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and takes.
That is caught. It's Cooper for the Cowboy touchdown. Amari Cooper, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. Slide for the PAT. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And last time, 1 play, interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a 1-play drive where you throw an interception, A lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped.
There's a nice pickup right there, and after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
They'll look to throw again. Over the middle, complete. It's Harris. And he will have a Giants first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First down, New York. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. There's Chark with a great grab. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he's got it. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll look to throw. And this will be well too low for him to bring in. It's incomplete.
But the passing windows are just not there. And that's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
And that is caught. He's got it for a Giant touchdown. A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Giants are able to draw a bit closer. Coaches must really like to see that from the quarterback because he's had the interceptions in this game, but they're able to connect on the touchdown pass.
And teammates love to see that because they know that they miss blocks during a game, but they come back and make them later on. They miss tackles, right? They miss making plays. But the spotlight is magnified on your quarterback. And when he stands up to the pressure and comes back and throws a touchdown pass after throwing some picks earlier, they feel great about that guy.
And likewise for him personally, as a rookie quarterback, has to give him more confidence. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Second and eight. And to give this time to the tailback. Able to power through. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. They run the counter now on first down. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3 yard gain.
Second down at 7. And now Murray's going to set up to throw. And firing a deep ball for Komet. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
The Cowboys on third down. They've been excellent, 6 for 7. This is 3rd and 7. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. 60 yards rushing for him now on 17 carries.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And now on the pitch, the ball's loose.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
The fumble on first down, now here's second down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And they'll get him down here at about the 42. That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity, usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Now they'll run the option to the short side left. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Kyler Murray, his 3rd touchdown of the game, number 14 on the year. And the Cowboys look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this 4th quarter. Extra point by Sly is up and good, and the lead will swell by 1 more. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 35. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. CD, this defense, man, at this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on, no one wants to come out of the game. They all want their shot at picking off a pass.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 78 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
They wind up losing a couple there, so they go behind the original line of scrimmage, and now 3rd and 11 coming up. Now a handoff here to his running back, and they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. And now defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. So now here comes the field goal team for the third time today. And his kick here is good. And that will just add three more to a lead that's already out of hand. So it's three more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And just looking ahead, it would appear that that bye week is coming at the right time. And the Cowboys pressure gets there this time for the sack. That one will set them back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. Back to throw. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there, it's going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding, probably his agent, as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
And Sharp calls it in. And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown, but they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it.
The Giant offense going to stay on the field as they'll go for two. They'll look to throw. That's caught, and he is not going to make it to the end zone. And that's pretty reflective of their game as a whole, as they'll remain down by a bundle. So it would no doubt be a miracle comeback from here, but let's see what they can do starting with the onside kick. And this one travels out of bounds, so unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. Give here to Pollard. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder
or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 93 yards rushing now for the ball game on 24 carries. Right back to him on first down. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It's a six-yard run. Leaves him with about a foot or so here still to go to hit the marker with third down coming up. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Cowboys, they move back over 500 now at 4-3. And they'll have another home date next week as the Miami Dolphins come to town. Meanwhile, for the Giants, they fall a game under the 500 mark at 3-4 through seven games. And they'll get an extra week to think about it as the midseason bye might be coming at just the right time.
Taking off with the race. Put the in my face.
I never knew that I would get the love from my state.
Stay with the blue, always keep the money coming in.
Ain't nothing new, writing it till I need another pen.
Gotta make the right decision, or it might just be my last.
People view everything different when you touching on the back.
What you see as good intentions is for clout and hitters, man.
You can never be yourself, you carry, gotta wear a mask.
They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up, trying to change you.
I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging.
Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this.
Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm pacing.
What up, Ant?
Down, ready, see, don't be too low, no, I need my leg. Coach, please sit him, young dog, can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost all respect. I'm gone, long for a deep look. Saint Louis, I got money, take care of man. Crash and I hit whoever long if we get past. Take it back to pound touchdown. Whoever thought I have a buzz down. Still sticking to the script, going deep. Still trying to take care of my people. Football ain't all I know. That was all I chose. Back to the road for me. If I'm provided, don't be how we gon' need that step. Just let a young know that step. I never knew my broke down. Ready, see, don't hit too low. No, I need my leg. Please sit him, young dog, can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost all respect. I'm gone down, ready, see. Don't hit too low, no, I need my leg. Coach, please sit him, young dog, can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost all respect. I'm gone.
Kick a punt, then I make a catch. 5,000 ones in an hour, I'ma make it stretch. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. I got cash by the bundle, so I never press. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. 50-yard TD with the winning catch. Oh no, oh no, oh no, no, no.
No.
tear me out. I think the tables are turned. Forget the bridge we don't build. It's time I let them all burn. They tried to kill me out. Well, now it's the word. I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the third. They count me out. Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling. See him from the view. Got my check up. And now I'm trying to blow a bag of two. Proud of shoot. And all designer drink it what I desire. Put him out. It's what I told him. Cause that boy he on fire. Walk in that thing and air it up. Been in my bag a little bit. Remember my pockets in a jar. I couldn't build a little chick. They say that Trini left his paper. You see that's a mill. That's why you catch all my brothers balling. And shooting no bricks. Hold up, check me out. I think the tables done turned. Forget the bridge and we don't build. It's time I let them all burn. They tried to count me out. Well, now it's the word. I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the third. They count me out, now count me in. Oh, I'm hot, sizzling. Don't count me out, it all begins right now. Catch me if you can. Never really care what they say.
On God,
only ever care about one thing. Chain, 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 rack A's, rack A's.
Hit the bank.
Ba-bang, ba-bang, put you in your play. Wait, they done got me started. Without me, it's not a party.
Nope.
Ma, he got it rocking. We bring havoc to your lobby. Tristan, he got shoddy. They gon' copy cause we poppin'. Blues up in my wallet. If I like it, then I cop it. Hold up, check me out.
Hold up.
I think the tables done turned. Forget the bridge we don't build. It's time I let them all burn.
They tried to kill me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I
bring
in
paper, 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 paper from the first to the third. They count me out. Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot.